Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Manchester for the weigh-in for Warrington versus Frampton. Just seen the weigh-in there. How's Corbyn in training camp?
Yeah, he's looked really good. It's been a pleasure to train alongside him these last couple of weeks. The gym's been buzzing. We had Rocky Fielding fighting. Obviously, that was an unfortunate loss last weekend, but Martin and Carl looking really good. I think the both at that stage in the career now where they need to put in these big wins. So, like I said again, it's been a pleasure training alongside him. I've learnt a lot and I'm excited now to see him executed on Saturday night.
Well, let's talk about Martin. Martin Murray's obviously in a very tough fight, and that the people who say talking about Martin's age and whatnot, this is maybe the last chance to learn. If he loses this fight, where does he go? Do you believe he can win this and possibly go on and fight for another world title?
I've not watched too much of the Dan, but I've seen how Martin's been performing in the gym. Like he said again earlier, he's enjoying boxing again. He fell out of love with it a couple of years ago, so he's flying in the gym. All the lads are getting on, pushing each other, working really hard. So I just really hope he get a good win on Saturday and put him back in that position to challenge for some of the big titles.
Again, let's talk about the main man himself, Carl Frampton against Josh Warrington. Both of them look really, really good in the skills there. A lot of people are split 50-50 down the line. Might be a dumb question, but who are you picking?
You can't ask me that. No, obviously I'm going to go for Carl Frampton, but not only that, I've been training at the side of now for a couple of fights, so I've been able to see the hard work that it takes to be a world champion. He's been a world champion, he's fighting again obviously for the world title, but I've learnt a lot of him. I'm excited for him, and I truly believe he's going to come through on Saturday night. I think Warrington, he definitely upset me, and I think he upset a lot of other people when he fought Lee Selby.
Lights have gone
out. Lights have gone.
There we go, back on.
Yeah.
And again.
And I didn't, he shocked me really, and I think he's done well, and you've got to give credit to Warrington for taking the fight, but I just believe that Carl's got too much for him, experience. He's been at the top level before, and I think that's what will carry him through this fight.
Well, the lights have been very dark in here, so I'll just ask one more question. What's next for you then? You had a good win over Harry Davis a couple of weeks back. What's next for you?
Yeah, I'm just enjoying being in the gym at the moment, learning, training with the rest of the fighters, and hopefully some big fights in 2019.
Well, there you go. I'll let you go because I can't see your face on this camera, but I'm still pushed out. Thanks for this fight.
No problem. Thank you very much.
Fight night. Cheers, buddy.
Thank you.